It's not often that a new RV builder catches the eye of RVers and other manufacturers so quickly. But one company that seems to be doing just that is Advanced RV. Located in Willoughby, Ohio, not only is this company being noticed, but they're also raising the bar when it comes to innovation and creativity in the custom Class B motorhome market. It's obvious from the moment you walk into their production facility that Advanced RV is not your typical RV builder. Instead, you'd swear you're in a NASCAR race shop. I mean, this place is meticulously organized and immaculate. And, like any professional race car operation, the vehicles that roll out of this shop are also meticulously engineered and built to each client's needs and desires. And then some. The person behind Advanced RV is Mike Nundorfer, who is also CEO of Nundorfer Incorporated, a very successful environmental engineering company he founded back in 1973. Besides the fact that Mike and his wife Marcia are avid adventure travelers, hiking and camping in places like Europe, Asia, and Russia, it was after a few experiences with RVing in the U.S. that got Mike thinking.
I started thinking about, I have a problem. I can't stop thinking about innovation. So the first time Marcia and I rented Class B in Chicago, we flew up there. It was a foot of snow, wet snow. It was in the spring. We were going to a wedding in Michigan. We rented this RV. The furnace quit the first night, got down to freezing. So there was a lot to innovate, even to think about innovation in that first one. I'm always thinking of a better way to do things. My mind won't stop doing that. Maybe it's part of the engineering training or whatever, but part of the fun of Advanced RV is not my innovation. I see needs, I identify those needs, even when we take trips now. And Marcia and I just got back from a trip to Florida with a brand new 2014 demo with a four-cylinder engine and an air ride. And that whole trip, we're writing down things that we observe, things that are different, things that we'd like to be different, things that we could improve. And I email those things back to the appropriate people on the team. And then when we get back, the fun of it is sitting down together and brainstorming and saying, yeah, we could do this, or we could do that, or we could use this part in two ways. One of our things is to try to think of it as a system and not as a bunch of blocks that you're throwing together. So as we design and innovate, we always try to think of two or three uses. We always think of redundancy. We try to think of what, if something breaks, how do you fix it? Are you stuck with a macerator that won't work? So all these things are a challenge, and the challenges become a joy when I can work with other talented people who have better ideas than mine most of the time. And then we can execute using the craftspeople that have 10, 15, 20 years of experience.
The way this company was created and operates is as different and well thought out as their vehicles. Maybe a little different than most people are used to. But hey, when you've been doing things this way since 1973, who can argue with success? At Advanced RV, you're not just an employee, you're part of a team. And this team is respected and treated very differently than in most companies.
Our team is amazing, and I have the luxury of creating a place to work where I would like to work. And what I want to do, the kind of people I want to work with, are people who love what they do, they're good at what they do, and they can create trust in each other and rise to a level of performance that people who don't work as a team and don't trust each other, aren't involved with the decisions of design and schedule. So my challenge is to figure out a way to create the kind of autonomy, the kind of self-direction, the kind of personal responsibility in this staff that makes it an amazing place to work. We don't have sick days. If somebody's sick, they stay home. We don't have vacations. If somebody plans a vacation, they should take a vacation. We don't keep track of vacations. My selection of people is people who are self-directed, have a lot of experience, and want to be part of an awesome team.
And this team build some of the most elegant, clean-looking RVs anywhere. As a matter of fact, they don't even look like typical RVs. And that is by design, as Mike explains.
We seek elegance, and the definition of elegance often includes what's not there. So we always look at how we can simplify things, how we can make it more elegant, and that's aesthetically and from a design standpoint. Some of our clients don't want any identification at all. They want to be stealth, and we respect that, and that's great. In fact, we've worked really hard to get all of the cutouts on the sides of the vans for vents. We've designed those away so that our latest model only has the shore power plug on the side. And the only reason that's on the side instead of underneath is so that people won't have to bend over to plug them in. But other than that, there's no other cutouts for grills or exhaust or anything else. So clients have named our advanced RV stealth models because they can go anywhere. They can park in their development without having the people who make the rules come and say, you got a motorhome there.
A good example of what Mike calls a stealth design is the side storage compartment built right into the lower side skirt of the vehicle. And alongside, also well concealed, is the utility compartment. Like any high-end luxury or performance car, a lot of its value comes from things you don't see. And the same is true for advanced RV. Take, for instance, the heating and hot water system.
We take a systems approach to every aspect of comfort and energy with advanced RV. And here's an example with a German manufactured, very small, efficient furnace that burns just a sip of diesel fuel from the tank. And it's located here. It heats up fluid that heats up the interior of the cab and the coach, and also heats hot water. It also keeps the fresh water plumbing from freezing. It's a very efficient system, and it all is located under chassis, so we open up a lot of room capability up in the coach, and it also is quiet. Part of the diesel heating system is a separate heat exchanger for hot water, which is under this insulation. Under this insulation is the glycol, high glycol line, and all of our plumbing. So we eliminate a lot of freezing potential by running the heated glycol on the same routing as the plumbing. This is a 40-gallon fresh water tank, which we've just begun to install.
Advanced also has a custom suspension system that will improve that already great factory install system, as Mike explains.
One of our demo models, this has an air suspension that we installed. This is the compressor totally sealed, and the air springs on the new springs. This is the lateral stability, and the anti-sway system is in the front of the axle now rather than in the back as the original was. It really works well. It eliminates the sway, reduces the bump in the road, maintains the elevation of the vehicle at the same point no matter what the load is. We're really pleased with it.
Coming up after the break, we'll check out the facility and see what goes into building a custom advanced RV. As we mentioned earlier, every advanced RV is custom built specifically for each client's needs and desires, so you won't find floor models sitting around here waiting to be sold. So, how do you get one of these? It all starts with a phone call, usually to Mike or Brittany Imorino. Once they understand what you're basically looking for, the design department goes to work in creating various options for you to look at and approve. In most cases, clients will come in and be part of the whole design process. Once all the design and engineering work is done and the vehicle arrives from Mercedes, it's the first thing is getting all the windows and vent openings cut out. Then, the vehicle gets not just one, but two different insulation packages. The first, like most RVs have, is a thermal insulation material. And the second is a high-tech sound deadening material called hush mat. Once that's in place, it's time for wiring. Advanced RV makes all its own wiring harnesses in-house, and each vehicle is pre-wired for everything you'll need, even if you don't need it now. Now that the wiring is all in place, a few things start happening simultaneously. Upstairs in the upholstery department, Chris Piercy applies his skills in stitching up some luxurious interiors out of virtually any material a client may want. The most popular being leather. Although, we did see an alligator hide waiting to get stitched up. While Chris is doing the upholstery, vehicles are not assigned production numbers? Nope. Each one has a name, and this one is Cindy. Anyway, the next step for Cindy is the cabinet and fabrication shop. And here is where the van starts transforming into an RV. Adam Stoopy is in charge of the cabinet shop, and we caught up with him as he was working on one of their unique kitchen cabinets.
Standard kitchen lower cabinet, which incorporates a number of features. The radius cabinetry is something we manufacture on site with vacuum press. We have integrated heat system here. Once this is installed in the chassis, this is the heater core, part of the S-bar system that fastens down to the floor. It is ducted internally. Both return and supply air are all integrated into this cabinet. This is also where the sink would go, the water pump, and a number of other mechanical features go underneath in this area. All of our drawers are solid maple, dovetail construction. We use side mount soft closing guides. And we have touch latch integrated hardware which holds the door closed. It's a positive latch. Over here on this side of the shop is where we install all of our cabinetry into the chassis. When we get it, the chassis has already been insulated, the rough and electric, the rough mechanical, plumbing and things of that nature, subfloor and finished floor have been installed. Then we start installing all of our components. You can see the upper cabinetry is in place, minus the doors, which are in process. This would be the wardrobe cabinet, where the refrigerator and microwave will end up being. The kitchen cabinet you saw earlier straddles this step and this area, situated right here. The additional upper cabinetry, bathroom, and light balance all get installed in this process. And all the way down to the granite and the countertops, and then on to wall panels and things of that nature. As we move back, like I said, things are in process. And this area is where the AV cabinet and the central computer system and everything is situated right here, not in place yet. In this area is where the bed or sofa bed, or in some cases double beds, will be installed. This all gets finished wall panels upholstered to the customer specifications. And we have a lot of doors and hardware and things to install, but you can see that there is, each one of these cabinets is basically modular, but also customized at the same time.
Now that we've seen what goes into designing and building the interiors, let's check out a couple of finished vehicles. As you see, there's more to that kitchen cabinet that Adam was building as Brittany demonstrates the pass-through compartment. As we mentioned earlier, every vehicle Advanced RV produces is virtually a one-of-a-kind to meet each client's needs. And some of those needs can be, well, shall we say, different? But this is where the advanced design team comes through, as Mike explains.
One couple travels with their two dogs to dog shows, about 20 dog shows a year. So we built separately ventilated, separately lighted, waterbed floored kennels underneath the owner's two twin beds so that they could travel in luxury and in comfort. One other big thing about traveling with pets is that we have studied and tested energy generation, storage, and use patterns so that we can help clients know what is realistic to expect off the grid. So in the case of the pet owners, where they want to go maybe take a walk or be away from the motorhome for 8 hours and make sure that their pets are safe, either cool enough or warm enough, we have a monitoring system. It's a cell phone app where they can check what's going on, what the temperature inside their motorhome is. They can leave the air on and be assured that if the batteries get low, that it'll start the engine or start a generator and recharge the batteries automatically.
Now that we know the dogs are comfortable and cozy, let's check out the rest of this beauty. Remember Mike mentioning the climate control system and solar panels? Here, They just don't bolt on prefab solar panels. No way. Check out the low contour forming panels on this unit. Once your RV is finished, there's one more important item that Advanced has raised the bar on, and that is your owner's manual. Each component, every system is laid out and explained in an owner's manual, not just in book form, but also digitally on a tablet that's easy to navigate. Before we ended our visit, we asked Mike a question that everyone is interested in knowing, and that is about the Advanced RV warranty policy.
Our warranty process is quite simple. Our objective is to get clients back on the road as quickly as possible with as least hassle as possible. So we encourage our customers, our clients, to stop wherever they want to, wherever they have confidence in somebody, call our 24/7 technical line. One of our technical people gets on with the technician at that location, talks them through the troubleshooting, and gives them a credit card number so that they're paid immediately for the estimate, for the work, and they know what they're doing.
Like we said at the beginning of the story, everything about Advanced RV is very different, and that goes for how well they take care of their customers after the sale. For more information on Advanced RV, visit their website at advanced-rv.com. Coming up next, we head south to the Big Easy.